Well, thank you for watching. I'm Rolly Hoyt. We begin with a story at the intersection of gun safety and race relations. An African-American family in Bryant is disturbed after their neighbor called the police on their 10-year-old son. The boy was outside doing what he loved, pretending to be a soldier with his toy guns. THB11's Jordan Howington says the incident leads to a larger conversation.
I want to be a Navy SEAL.
10-year-old Jackson has hopes and dreams to one day serve his country.
Well, I like pretend that I'm like in the military with these toy guns playing around, making sound effects.
Reinforcements! For a while now, he's used the creek in his backyard to wade through the waters as if he was on a real assignment. No problems until recently.
There's a young black man, that young black man, boy-ish, walking behind my house with what he says is not a real gun, which I believe him in that.
A neighbor called police on him after he explained to her it was a toy gun.
I mean, I have bird feeders, and he's got this toy gun that he's walking behind my house with.
And he came in the house really, really upset.
Jackson's parents are hurt that this really happened in their community.
I can't shoot birds with this toy gun. So why? Why after all of that would you call? The only thing that I could gather from that is that, you know, it may have been because of his skin color.
When the officer arrived, he gave Jackson advice, one being about the little orange cap on the tip of the gun, telling him to keep it on, because when that's off, the officer has a split second to make a decision. And that's why his parents are raising awareness. This call could have ended differently.
Frivolous calls that can result in the death of a person or the death of a child.
Now, Jackson's parents say they're even more fearful for their son.
I feel that toy guns aren't meant to be bought for black children, which is very, very sad.
He didn't do anything wrong. He was just playing and being a little boy.
Todd Krausen with Bryant PD says he hopes this situation doesn't kill Jackson's dreams of becoming a Navy SEAL.
Don't let this stop him from going out back and playing and playing Army or Navy SEAL, whatever he wants to do.
Jordan Howington, THV 11 News.
Now, Jordan attempted to speak with the neighbor, but she never responded. Jackson's mother posted about her son's experience on Facebook, and she says she's gotten an outpouring of support from all over, including from those right in her own neighborhood.